Hello YouTube, Alex from Arcane MTG here, and today I'm going to showcase a deck and some gameplay that I used for the recent Win Any Card event on MTG Arena. The deck was called Fires of Golos. I can't play it now because I obviously didn't win every card, but that's okay. 12 wins is a lot to get in a row, and I don't think anyone should have been going into that event expecting to win it. I did pretty well though, and I was pretty happy with it, apart from a massive derp on my part. The mind was not functioning, all cylinders were not firing at that point, so, you know, hindsight is 20/20. That's okay. So this deck is a spin on a very popular meta deck, which revolves around Field of the Dead, a land which, when you have seven or more lands with different names on the field, and another land enters the battlefield, it creates a 2/2 zombie for you. So the deck revolves around this, and Golos the Tireless Pilgrim, which is another incredible card, which can tutor Field of the Dead from your deck straight onto the field, and just ramp you up very quickly into getting a large number of zombies on the board every turn, because you can have multiple Field of the Dead lands on the board at the same time, thus giving you three or four 2/2 zombies every time you play a land. The deck gets to a very high power level very quickly, and a lot of the other cards, such as Arboreal Grazer, and Circuitous Route, and for me, I think an unusual inclusion, which is Beanstalk Giant. A lot of these cards revolve around getting cards straight from your deck onto the battlefield so that you can quickly ramp up to where you want to be and combat kind of. And it works using these tutor cards, running a large number of lands with different names for obvious reasons. I chose to. Usually the deck is focused around white, blue, and green. It's called Bant Golos is the normal title of it. I decided to take a strange spin on that and include four of this new Throne of Eldraine card, Fires of Invention. Card reads, you can cast spells only during your turn, and you can only cast two per turn. But you can cast them with converted mana cost less than or equal to the number of lands you control without paying their mana cost, which effectively means that if you've got six lands on the board, you can pay two 6-drops and still have six mana left, which is actually pretty crazy, and it works very well when you have Golos in hand. You play Fires of Invention, and which, by the way, only counts as one card having been played that turn, so you can play another 4-drop or even a 5-drop if you can play another land that same turn. It's just a really powerful combination, and allows you to use your mana for things other than playing cards, such as mana sinks like Golos's ability, which lets you cast the top three cards of your library for free. Kenrith, the Return King, is also a very, very popular mana sink to use with Fires of Invention, with the spare mana you have hanging around. In particular, in this deck, his haste, the ability of spending one red mana to give all creatures you control haste and trample until the end of the turn, is incredible, because you are generating, you know, often five or six zombie tokens per turn, and they're all going to have summoning sickness. But if you've got this guy out and just one red land, they no longer have summoning sickness, and it can end games very fast. For the final component, it's quite a multi-component deck, sorry about that, but we've also got board wipes in there. There's a bit of synergy with Realm Cloaked Giant, Time Wipe, allowing you to return him to your hand, and also Beanstalk Giant can come out as a late game beater. He comes out with, in fact, his toughness and power are equal to the number of lands you control. So when you're getting the number of lands on the board that we are, he is often quite big. The final component of this multi-component deck is Fate of Wishes. A very popular card in Standard right now, which allows you to tutor any non-creature card from outside the game, which in the strange language of Magic the Gathering Standard means in your sideboard, which basically allows you to pick a variety of powerful options which and tune those picks to the deck you're facing off against at the time. So we've got the Elder Spell for Planeswalker heavy decks, we've got Teferi because he's just annoying, we've got a variety of board wipes such as Planar Cleansing if you just want to get rid of every single card your opponent has because they're doing too much stuff and you want them to stop. I put in Thought Distortion, incredible against control decks, effectively won me one of the games I was playing. Got 4 or 5 cards out of your opponent's hand, turn 5 or 6, that's pretty game winning. Another card which is great in the mirror against other Field of the Dead decks is Ethereal Absolution, which turns your zombies into 3/3s and theirs into 1/1s. If you play two of them, which is the reason I've got two in here, then every zombie that they play comes into the field and then just immediately dies because they've got -2/-2. It's pretty this turned out to be a pretty key card for me. I will end this very long explanation there, and the gameplay is uncommented. I'm sorry about that. I was having microphone troubles having just got back from traveling, but I hope you find the games interesting, and yeah, enjoy.